Hello, my name is Urvashi Sengal and I'm an RF applications engineer at Mini Circuits. In one of our previous episodes, we talked about balanced versus unbalanced systems and how balance fit into the big picture. This time, we will talk about some of the different applications for balance and how they are used. So, what is a balance? Balance are the most common RF devices used in modern communication system to provide a smooth transition between balanced and unbalanced systems. Balance are present in radars, transmitters, satellites, and in every phone network, and probably in most wireless network modems, routers used in a home. In general terms, the balanced transformer has some common uses. When we think of balance, usually the following uses come to mind. Impedance matching to achieve maximum power transfer, bias injection and DC isolation, common mode rejection in balanced architectures, even order harmonic suppression for push and pull amplifiers, RF splitter and combiner, and double balanced mixer. In this video, we will take a look at two of these applications, bias injection and DC isolation, and even order harmonic suppression. First, let's talk about bias injection and DC isolation. This is where an RF transformer can be designed to provide DC isolation between the primary and the secondary windings, which is useful for separating RF circuits requiring a DC bias from circuits negatively impacted by a DC voltage. If a DC current is required for a portion of the circuit, a specialized RF transformer can be used to inject current into the signal path. For example, configuration H transformers can inject a DC bias and replace two bias Ds. This will definitely eliminate a traditional bias D approach to provide the DC. It will simplify the PCB layout and save space. The other balanced application we will get into this video is even order harmonic suppression, which is a big deal in wideband cable TV applications. 3 dB higher payout and IP3 than a single device. Wideband communication systems have signals occupying a multi-octave frequency range. For example, CATV signals occupy 50 to 1000 MHz range, which is more than 4 octaves. Such signals, when amplified in conventional amplifiers, can be distorted due to the second order products generated inside the amplifier. For example, the second order harmonics of 50 MHz signal is 100 MHz. Second harmonic of 400 MHz is 800 MHz, and both are within the band. An ideal push-pull amplifier can cancel the internally generated products and preserve the signal quality. It consists of two balanced and two identical amplifiers. When a signal is applied to the input of the first balance, the output signal from the same balance consists of two signals of equal amplitude and out of phase. These signals are amplified combined in output balance. The gain of a push-pull amplifier is same as that of an individual amplifier, whereas the output power is twice that of an individual amplifier. A push-pull connection is frequently used for combining the power of two individual amplifiers. As an example, Mini Circuits PHA 11 Plus consists of a pair of amplifiers. As they are on the same chip, their gain and phase are very well matched. If a balanced signal is applied to the input of PHA 11 Plus, then the output is also balanced. By using a set of balance at the input and output, a single-ended input is first converted into a balanced signal in T1, amplified in PHA, and then combined in the transformer T2 to produce a single-ended output. IP2 of such an amplifier is more than 72 dBm. Well, now you understand a bit more about uses for balance and some important applications for these essential components. Mini Circuits balance are an excellent choice for such applications. If you would like to learn more about balance and other products Mini Circuits offers, take a look on our website at www.minicircuits.com. Thanks for watching. See you next time.